It's used many ways, honestly. Sometimes it's a screw you, sometimes it's a way to seem less bitchy while being gossipy, sometimes it's an actual expression of sympathy. What's an insult that sounds like a compliment? You're much smarter than you look. Some asshole told me that once. I just said, and you're dumber than you look. That was the day I learned blondes are stereotyped to be stupid. That outfit is really brave. I had someone describe my scrubs like that a couple of weeks ago. I still don't know if to be offended or honored by that. My grandma used to tell us that if you ever met an ugly baby you should said, wow, that is some baby. Here's a picture of my baby, isn't he cute? Oh, would you look at him? You are impossible to underestimate. Another similar one, don't worry, my opinion of you hasn't dropped a bit. My grandma always says people are good and kind when they get on her nerves. They think she's a sweet old lady, when she's really saying they're good for nothing and kinda stupid. I got it engraved on a mug for her. Your sister is beautiful and you are smart. I've heard this a lot in my life and I'm not even that smart. Relatable, I'm the ugly sister. But I'm apparently so smart, as though my beautiful sister isn't smart at all. She's cute and smart and I love her. Does it have to be a competition? See you later. Not if I see you first. I always thought it was just a cheesy response, but no, the implication is that if you see the other person, you bail before they see you. You're at the top of the bell curve. Most of them are backhanded compliments, but this is a flat-out insult whose mood and words seem complimentary. It's ingenious. Top of the hierarchy, top of the world, top tier. Top of the bell curve. This is the only one I'm actually saving for later. Whether this is an insult really depends on the person. It's made for pretentious people who think they're at the right end of the slope, or but also constantly mention it. Another odd thing is, you're at the bottom of the slope, which either means you're exceptionally stupid or exceptionally smart. You look healthy, where I'm from, the nice way of saying someone has gotten fat. Whereas in China, they don't beat around the bush when it comes to weight. You got fat, is exactly what someone's parents or grandparents would say after returning home from abroad. I teach ESL to adults. One really sweet Chinese student, I think he was on the spectrum, for what it's worth, once told me, "Teacher, you look less fat than before," as a compliment. I calmly explained that I wasn't upset with him, but he probably shouldn't say that to people, because it may upset them. But I say less fat, teacher. No, I get it, buddy, but just, it's a good idea not to use fat, even if you want to compliment someone. You know what? It's really best to just say nothing about people's sizes at all, ever, especially with women. Why? It's cultural, it makes us upset. If you want to be nice, you can say, you look nice today, just don't mention their body. Makes sense. It did not, but he enthusiastically assured me he would no longer comment on others' bodies in English. You talk so eloquently, or, you speak so well, towards a black person as if we all talk like we're from the depths of the hood. I once called an Uber for my brother and I called the driver to tell him where to pick him up. We live in South Africa and the driver was white, so when my brother got home he told me the driver asked if he was adopted. It turns out the driver who was white thought that I was white based on my voice, so that meant my brother had to be adopted. It was pretty funny. You're so confident. This has got to be a kick to the nuts. Said in the right tone that must suck. Cause you know homeboy built up quite some courage to rock those assless chaps, and now Aunt Karen just dropped that bomb on you at the family Christmas party. Your dick is so cute. My girlfriend says stuff like this all the time. I'm not especially worried about the size of my weenie, but nothing gives you pause quite like, ah, look at your cute little penis. I woke up to my GF staring at my soft meat and she was like, it's so cute, it's crazy how small it is when it's not hard, and I was like, okay, ouch. Dude, don't worry about it, growers are literally the genetically and evolutionarily superior beings. You know why I think that? It's because when you're soft, it's out of the way and hardly any blood is going there, meaning you don't have to worry too much about it hitting things or getting caught, and you're smarter. Then when you need it, the thing's big. It's a meat log and it's ready to hog. It's a size that's enough to pleasure whatever lucky lady you have. I don't care what everybody else says, I think you're pretty cool. My ex used to tell me that all the time. Took me a while to figure out he was trying to isolate me from others. How would you say that in a non-joking way? I can't imagine saying this without a really stupid smile on. To my friend, you have cooler friends than I do. I always tell my girlfriend I have better taste than her because I'm dating her while she's dating me. What a chump. That's a compliment that sounds like an insult. Friends and I do this thing where you add the word actually to an otherwise normal compliment in order to make it backhanded. For example, hey, you're actually pretty smart. That's actually pretty funny. The classic, I hope your day is as pleasant as you are. Or, I hope you have the day you deserve. This is coming from a retail worker to a full Karen. I went to my friend's wedding reception and inadvertently toasted, I hope the two of you get all the happiness you deserve. I realized my horrendous mistake as soon as my ass hit the chair. You're pretty for a big girl. I had a weird interaction in China, a gym trainer came to me in broken English. GT, here, take hands me a flyer. Me, keeps walking. GT, for you. Me, walks faster. GT, you're fat, I can make you beautiful. Me, stops, turns, speaks in Mandarin, are you saying I'm not beautiful? GT, looks terrified and tries to run away. I've heard, you look good despite your skin tone, used a few times, by people with a not very different skin tone, lol. Whenever my friends are told, you're pretty for a black, Samoan girl. If I wasn't 4 feet 10 inches, I'd punch those douches for them. On the contrary, you are the perfect height to headbutt them in the jewels. Go for it. P.S. I am 6 feet 6 inches and for some reason am attracted to girls that are much shorter. Probably the prospect of carrying them around under my arm like a plank. One of the guys I was dating told me, you share your emotions and feelings quite often. I took it as I probably talk too much about things and shouldn't, but he told me that no, it's a good thing and it helps. Still made me think twice the next time I wanted to share things. I don't know half of you half as well as I should like, and I like less than half of you half as well as you deserve. He's saying that he would like to know some of them better, and less than half of them deserve to be liked twice as much as he likes them. It's a compliment that sounds like an insult, not vice versa. That's nice, dear. I've got a tattoo of a UFO beaming someone up and quite often older folks mistake it for the Space Needle. When they ask to look at it and they realize that it isn't what they thought, their smile drops and I'll get a, that's nice honey, I don't care that it's an insult. I think it's funny. Wow, you're so brave, or I wish I had your confidence, said completely deadpan. Add an exclamation point and the vibe can be changed. I compliment people on their confidence, often from a place of genuine admiration or pride for that person, and was surprised to see this listed as an insult until I saw examples. I think it comes down to your inflection when you say it, the context, and how you say it. For example, Sarah, I love how confident you are on stage. You're a natural, you've come so far, I'm so proud of you, or, Sarah, you're always so confident, could be a compliment. Something like, gosh, I love your confidence, of I wish I had your confidence, while casting a judgmental look over an outfit or someone's body would be an insult, in that it's clear it's not a genuine compliment, and there's an unspoken implication that the person is or has to be confident, because they or their outfit doesn't look good. In the words of the late Reverend Spooner, you are a shining wit. It's the most British insult I know. For the uninitiated, a spoonerism is where you swap the starting sounds of two words. So shining wit becomes. So this takes me back to high school, which, back then, we couldn't swear in class. One of my classmates was apparently aggravated at another and yelled, you talk too mucking fuch. I could see the teacher's expression go from incredulous to resigned to amused as she realized the game was changed. If you are in the South, bless your heart. It's used many ways, honestly. Sometimes it's a screw you. Sometimes it's a way to seem less bitchy while being gossipy. Sometimes it's an actual expression of sympathy. A. Karen comes into the grocery store and wants to return some bought on sale meat that she left in the fridge for a week. It's spoiled now. She demands the manager. Cashier says, "I'll get him right away, bless your heart." Bonus points for "bless your little heart," but service people usually can't get away with that level of sass. Must be said with the utmost wide-eyed innocence to get away with it. B. Gossip. I saw Kayla from high school and she must have gained 30 pounds since that last kid. I hardly recognized her, bless her heart. C. Genuine sympathy. Hey Jen, do you think you can give me a ride home from work? I hit a deer on the way home from Jamie's softball game last night. Jen, oh my goodness, bless your heart. Everyone is okay. Is the insurance going to cover it?
Like and subscribe for more funny, interesting, and scary r/askreddit videos.